Two-time Super Bowl champ, Super Bowl 40 MVP, Hines Ward here on the Will Cain Show. Let's talk about your old team. Let's talk about the Steelers for a moment. First, what's your impression overall with what's going on with Antonio Brown? Do you think he's going to be a Steeler? And if not, why?
I hope so. You know, I just think the Antonio Brown, the Pittsburgh Steelers, it's just the hard work, the fans, they love him. I just think sometimes, you know, his antics sometimes kind of take over the player who he really is. You look at the players, just hearing from them in a locker room, they like him. They want him to be a part of that. I know he's very integral in Juju's second year and, you know, his years in the league. And every time I talk to Juju, he always speaks highly of Antonio. And I was blessed to have him as a rookie. You know, he was a young buck, and I just saw the potential in him, how the hard work that he put into it. So it's unfortunate that you see some of the things that are coming out of our organization that is more about off the field rather than on the field. And AV sometimes get the bad rap because, yes, he's a competitor, but sometimes I think, you know, the me attitude or the me stats kind of takes over the team or takes over him, and it leads to situations. And I just think great talent, no question about it. I just sometimes some of those things like that need to be kept in-house. I just think that the Steelers, whoever the leader is, the leadership there, they just do a poor job of kind of keeping it in-house. They always air out their business, and that's the reason why you see some of the distractions that exist in the Pittsburgh Steelers organization.
Well, I have to follow up on that, talking to Hines Ward here on the Will Cain Show. Whoever the leadership is, sometimes it doesn't stay in-house. They air it out. You know, I think everybody knows some of the problems with Antonio Brown revolve around Ben Roethlisberger. You played with Ben for years, or at least as way Antonio would tell it. I think it has to do with the relationship with Ben Roethlisberger. Ben, certainly somebody that talks to the media. He does talk about issues. He isn't shy. What you've been with Ben, or you were with Ben for a long time, what is it about Ben that's different than other quarterbacks? I mean, from our side of the spectrum, Hines, we see it, and it's like, well, Ben sure talks more than other quarterbacks. He talks about issues, and now you hear it from players like Antonio. So describe for me what it is about Ben that could or could not be contributing to this.
I just know when you're looked at as a captain, sometimes it's not always good to air out people's criticism, you know. I just know players really don't like other players talking about them in the media, you know. I know Ben has a radio show in Pittsburgh, and sometimes, you know, when you criticize your teammates without talking to them personally, it rubs people the wrong way. And I know, I've heard it. You know, you talk about a band of brothers. We always talk about what a band of brothers. Well, treat me like a bigger brother. You're the bigger brother. Come talk to me. You don't have to call me out in the media to criticize me, saying that, you know, certain things that he's already said on air and the radio. All you do is open up a can of worms when you're doing that. And now other players think that they can criticize others. And you looked at the Le'Veon Bell situation. You had the whole offensive lineman talking about how much money they make. That is a major no-no. It's kind of an unwritten rule in the league. You don't talk about other people's contracts, period. You don't really supposed to talk about your teammates in general to the media. So I just think the leadership there, I don't know if it's there or it exists, but I know when you have your head guy, the captain, criticizing players, that doesn't sit well with a lot of players in the league in general.
Well, wait, one more follow-up, Hines, and it's these follow-ups are because I hear you and I'm genuinely curious in what you say. So when you said leadership the first time around and airing it out, I did kind of assume you were talking about Ben. And now hearing you follow up, I do think, is it Ben you're talking about, the leadership that needs to stop airing it out? Are we talking about Ben Roethlisberger?
Well, I think it's everybody. I think it's Mike Tomlin as well. It's Mike Tomlin, Antonio Brown, it's Ben Roethlisberger. It's not just one person, one incident. I just think, you know, from the head coach, we have too much talent on that team not to be in the playoffs. And that's a reflection of the head coach and leadership. So I think everyone's kind of got their hand in the cookie jar. And hopefully, you know, all three guys or whoever else is a leader in that group can sit down, lock the door, and hash it all out and start preparing for football. it's embarrassing for me, being a former player, that we talk more about the off-the-field stuff than rather on the field. I saw my Steelers beat the defending Super Bowl champions in Heinz Field. That's what it should be about. It should be about the play. It shouldn't be about the extra stuff that goes along with our organization.
All right.
That's not our culture. That's never been the Steelers' culture.
The MVP of Super Bowl 40. Are you the last receiver to win the MVP before Julian Edelman? I think you are, right?
No, San Antonio.
San Antonio. Another Steeler.
Antonio. Yeah. So it's good to see receivers win it, man. But, you know, Julian Edelman, the guy's just clutch. I mean, I don't know. People say all this Hall of Fame and stats. I just know the eye test. When I watch Julian Edelman, in the games that matter the most, man, the guy rises to the occasion all time and time again. So kudos to him. Congratulations, Super Bowl MVP, man. Well deserved.